Hi friends, this is Arvind here. Welcome to my networking channel. Hope all are doing good. And today let us discuss the telnet access issue. So this is our architecture where I connected R1 and R2. So R1 I defined the IP address 1.1 and R2 is 192.168.1.2. So due to some reason from R1 I am not able to telnet to R2 router. So that is the issue, not able to telnet to R2. So we need to go ahead and fix the issue. So let us go to R1 and first let us check the interfaces, right? So let us check by pinging the interfaces 1.2 I am able to reach. And also check from R2 whether any admin shutdown we have done 192.168.1.1 we are able to reach. So now let us check from telnet 192.168.1.2. So it is showing access denied, right? So telnet access issues might be an access list problem also. Let us go to R2 and let us do show run include access. So for telnet restrictions, what we'll do, we'll use a command access class. So access class is a command for denying or allowing access. That is a restriction we'll use for telnet. So if you want to allow any specific user, you can allow, or if you want to restrict, you can restrict using the access class command. So that is the purpose of telnet access. Before that, let us also start the capture. So telnet works on the protocol TCP, right? So let us start, and now let us do a telnet again. So you can see it is showing the protocol. It is working through TCP, right? TCP, and this is the protocol 1.1 and 1.2, and the telnet works on protocol TCP. So now let us see one thing. Let us go to R2 and let us check the access list. So access list is denying, right? It is denying the specific host 192.168.1.2. So that is the main reason. So from R1 I am not able to telnet to R2, right? So let us fix the issue. Let us go to R2. What we can do, just remove the access list 10. And let us allow access. How to do access list 10 permit 192.168.1.0 this subnet followed by the mask. So 0.0.0.255. Right. So I given that. So now let us do, now let us check it out whether we are able to telnet, right? So let us go to now R1. Also I run the packet capture. Let us see now. So do a telnet 192.168.1.2. Yeah. So now it is asking for username. Username is set it as server and the password the same thing. Then it will ask for the enable secret server. So now I'm able to telnet to the 192.168.1.2 because through the access class command, we can just allow or restrict the permission for a user or an administrator, right? So now you can see the packet flow. So we're able to see, right, from 1.1 to 1.2, we have done telnet. So it is showing the protocol as telnet, and from 1.2, it is getting the reply. That is the reason we are getting the acknowledgement from R2 to R1. This is from R1 to R2. So this is a protocol you are seeing, telnet as a protocol. And TCP, the source port will be the some random port, and the destination port will be the 23. This is from source to destination, and from destination to source, you can see source port as a 23 and the destination port as a random protocol, right? So a random port. So it works on always a protocol TCP. So now you understand how to allow or restrict any access permission for a telnet, right? So this is a way you can debug the any telnet issues. So also in case if you want to allow only the specific network administrator to allow access and remaining user you want to deny, you can restrict the access through telnet access class command. So this is how you can debug the telnet issue. So I hope you enjoy this video. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos. Thanks and have a wonderful day.